Good morning, students. I hope you all are very fine. And today I am going to take your basic, regarding tenses, because you also know tenses are very important part of our teaching or learning or anything in English language. Without tenses, you can't go ahead. So, in today's video, I am going to start with simple present tense. You already know that we use present tense to talk about actions that take place in the present or at the time of speaking. We use simple present tense to talk about the present moment. For example, Divya is at school. Saiba has a bad cold. This is the uses of where you have to use simple present tense. Just listen it very carefully. Facts and general truths. For example, Roger Federer plays tennis. Here we add S, as I have already told you in last standard also. Here, if the person is singular, third person singular, so we add S in verb. So Roger Federer plays tennis. An average housefly lives for about 3 weeks. An average housefly lives. Here also ES is there. For about 3 weeks. Something that happens regularly. Third use of simple present tense. Something you are habitual of. Something that happens with you regularly. For example, Sumedha practices yoga every morning. Sumedha practices yoga every morning. It is her daily habit to practice yoga. So Sumedha practices. Grandpa waters. It is grandpa's daily habit. Grandpa waters the plants in the evening. Waters. Grandpa is third person singular, so we add S here. Things that are planned for a near future. Fourth use of simple present tense is things that are planned for near future. For example, the players leave for England next week. The players leave for England next week. Not so much time is there. It is near future. Safa's father retires in a month. Okay. What is happening right before the speaker's eyes? Silva tackles Kurz, gets the ball and passes it to Marcelo. Here tackles. Silva is singular. So tackles is here. Kurz and gets. Gets, we add S here. It is also because Silva is a third person singular. And passes, again third person singular verb is there, so we added ES. Rahane hits the ball over the boundary for a six. Hits. Rahane hits. Okay. Now see, here some exercise is there, but as this is only revision, I am continuing second tense. It is present continuous tense. We use present continuous tense to talk about an action that is happening at the present moment. Action is going on. Here we have to take care in present continuous tense. Action is going on at a present moment, or it's happening at a present moment. To form the present continuous tense, we use the present form of the verb be and ing form of the main verb. For example, Rashmi is making tea. Okay, at this moment the making of tea is going on. Mahavir is pouring milk for the cat. Is pouring. Subject plus amizar plus verb plus ing. So Mahavir is pouring milk for the cat. Next, the present continuous tense is also used to talk about what something that is happening now and will continue for some time later. Present continuous tense, we are also using something that happening now and will continue for some time later. I am learning Chinese. Here the process is going on, but after some time I will continue it also. I will continue. Okay, so I am learning Chinese, because Chinese or any language you can't learn in a 2-3 days. It is a continuous process. So I am learning Chinese. My brother is studying law. It is not also for a month's period, it is years period. So my brother is studying law. Something annoying that happens repeatedly. You are always running about barefoot. Something that happens repeatedly. You are always running about barefoot. Piyush is constantly disturbing the class. This is Piyush's constant habit. This is always you are at a, about a barefoot. You know, for these habits we are using present continuous tense, and the formula is subject plus amizar plus verb plus ing. Okay, now again here exercise is there, but I am going to start and revise present perfect tense. Okay, now pay attention. We use present perfect tense to talk about the things that have happened at the time before the present. The time is not specific or clear. Before present, the things have happened, but time is not specific. Fali has finished lunch. When he finished, we don't know. But yes, he has finished. Fali has finished lunch. The flight has arrived. At exactly what time it arrived, we don't know. The flight has arrived. Subject plus have or has plus past participle of the verb. Here the flight is subject, has is verb, and past participle arrive, arrived, and arrived. Okay, now see here the actions occurred. Here the actions occurred sometimes before the present, but we don't know exactly when. Exactly when the this tense, what happened more important than when it happened. In this tense, what happened is more important instead of when it happened. The present perfect tense is formed with the present tense to have and the past participle of the main verb. The action shown by the present perfect tense may be complete or it may be continuing in the present moment. For example, money has solved the sum correctly. Action completed. Solving sums action has been completed. We have already walked 2 miles in 20 minutes. Action still going on. We have already walked 2 miles 20 minutes. In 20 minutes we have completed this one, but here action of walking is still going on. So here we can understand that we can use here past participle also with the main verb. Now see, it was here regarding present tense. Now simple past tense, another tense is simple past tense. The past tense is used to talk about actions that occurred in the past or conditions that existed in the past. We use simple past tense to talk about an action completed in the past. For example, Arman met his cousins yesterday. Now see the formula. Arman is subject, meet is the past tense of meet. Okay, so Arman met his cousins yesterday. Ifat went to Canada last year. Ifat is here subject and past tense of go, went. So our formula will be subject plus past tense of the main verb. Okay, so here you have two minimum collection of 200 or 300 past tense. Something that happened over a period of time in the past. For example, Nirav lived in Pune for 3 years. Nirav is subject here. Past tense of live is lived here. Nirav lived in Pune for 3 years. That is where he learned German. He learned. Past tense of learned. He learned German. Habitual actions in the past. If someone is habitual with any action, we use simple past tense. For example, in Lander, we went for a long walks every morning. This was the habitual of us in Lander. Okay, so we went, we is subject here, went is past tense of go. We went for a long walks every morning. My grandmother read a story. So see, past tense of read is read. My grandmother read a story to me every afternoon when I was a child. This is habitual action. When I was a child, my grandmother read a story for me. Okay, and now again, in meanwhile, we are going to take past continuous and past perfect tense. Okay, so we will stop here. Take care of you nicely.